is e to e plus t, then e to t, then t to t multiplication f, and then t to only f, then f to in bracket e, and f to id, right? So first thing what we have to do, we have to augment this grammar. How? We will add a new starting symbol to the grammar e dash, which will point to the current starting symbol, which is e. Okay, then what we have to do, we have to calculate the closure set for this first first production rule we have got. So how we do that? We put a dot here. Okay, this dot indicates that this e will needed to process, and we have to add production rule for this e. So we have added these two production rule for e. So we put dot here and dot here. Again, after dot, one non-terminal t came, it indicates that we have to add production rules headed by t. Okay, so we added next two production rules by adding dots here. Okay, and after dot again we got f, so we have to generate the production rule for add the production rule headed by f. So we have added these two production rules. All right, so this this set of items right now we will call as I0 or I0 item set. Okay, so this is I0 item set. Okay, next what we will do, I have just told you that after dot what is there, we have to process them. Okay, so you look at first production rule, after dot we have e. So we will behave, or we will do here like we are doing some we are doing some finite automata transition. Okay, so we will do it by doing transition. Okay, and for the transition, for which symbol you are doing the transition, that symbol will be written on the arrow. Okay, so this arrow is representing a transition. Okay, now here we are doing it for capital E. Okay, now what happens? Look at this very carefully. Okay, what will happen? This dot will be just jumped one step ahead. Okay, so here, and we can do this transition only for those symbols which are having dot on the left side, or which symbols are appearing on the right side of some dot. Okay, so this e is appearing on the right side of the of a dot in the first production rule. So we are going to do it for this e. So the result we'll get is e dash 2 e, and dot will be jumped one step. Okay, so after dot there is nothing, right? After dot there is nothing. So if after dot there is nothing, we don't need to add any more production rule for this. But when you are doing this transition for e, we have another thing here, that is the second production rule, where again the same e is appearing after dot. So we have to process that as well. So now if we process this, we will get e dot. So this dot, here we had a dot, this dot jumps one step, then plus, then t. Now see, look at this. After dot we have plus, which is terminal, so we don't need to add anything, right, for plus. So we don't need to add any production rule, as there is a terminal symbol after dot. Okay, this is very important to remember. If after dot you are finding as non-terminal, then you have to add production rule for this non-terminal symbol. But if after dot you are getting a terminal, then you don't need to add anything. Okay, so this is something to remember here. So we don't need to add anything else to this set. So this item set I close here and I name it as I1. Okay. Now, when we augment the grammar, we also assume that, you know, there is a dollar after the first production rule, but we don't write it. Okay. We assume that there is a dollar. Okay. Because when we will do parsing, we will have a stack, and at the bottom of the stack or the empty stack, or will hold a dollar at the bottom. Okay, so this we assume a dollar is there. So you can see when this dot can come at the end or after the start symbol of the E, it means that your E is processed and you reached to E, right? That means we can say that dollar is there only, which is the, you know, augmented symbol for your input string as well. Okay, so when your dot is just looking at dollar, that means what? Your dot will declare that your parsing was successful and your input string was accepted. Okay, so if the input gets a dollar, then we say it is accept. So you know, for every problem, this is you have to do by your own consideration. Okay. So in every, you know, everywhere, for every example, you will find for dollar, you know, when this start symbol is going on the left side of the dot, this transition is there. For this dollar, it is going to accept state. Okay, so this is, you have to remember and you have to do by yourself. Okay, and explanation I have already told you why it is there. Okay, now look, come back to our first item set, what we had generated, I0, right? In I0 item set, right now we will see what other symbols are appearing after dot. Okay, if you look at the third production rule, after dot T is coming, so we will have another transition for this capital T. Okay, and this item set will have E2T. Another rule is there where also T is appearing on the right side of the dot. See, for this current one, I don't need to add anything because the dot is at the end and after dot there is nothing. Okay, so we're not going to add any production rule for this transition. Okay, another is there, that is T2. We have to write T.*, or multiplication F, right? So after dot here, there is a terminal symbol. So again, we don't need to add anything here. Okay, so we can say that this item is this much, and we can finalize it. Now name this as I2. Okay, this is item set 2. Okay, then after dot, what is appearing? After dot, you can see that F is appearing, right? So good thing is that here T2 dot will jump by one step. Okay, so this is what for F, right? And after dot there is nothing, so we don't need to add anything here. All right, then after dot, what is there? F is done. Then after dot, this opening bracket is there. Okay, so if we do this, it will give us F2. Okay, this item set, I had to give a name, that is say I3. Okay, so here for this production rule, we have to have, we will have opening bracket dot jumped one step, then dot, okay, E closing bracket. Now here you look at this, after dot you have capital E, right? And capital E is a non-terminal, right? So we have to add production rule headed by capital E, right? So what are the production rules we have which are headed by capital E? We have E to E plus T, dot at the beginning. E to E plus T. Okay, anything else? Yes. Then E to dot T. Now again, after dot T came, so we have to think about that. So we have to add production rules headed by T. So what are those production rules? T2 dot T multiplication F and T2 dot F. Again, you can see after dot another non-terminal came, that is F. So we have to add F to dot opening bracket E closing bracket and F to dot ID. Okay, so we get another set. Okay, so this set we name as I4. Why this set happened? Due to opening bracket was after this dot. Okay, then then F to dot ID is there. Okay, so this can give us F to ID dot, because dot is jumped by one step. And you can see here that there is nothing we need to add, right? Because after dot there is nothing. So this was a transition for ID. Okay, give a name for this set, say I5. All right, next we have to say, you know, again for each of these sets what we have created, that where there is some symbol after dot, if there is some symbol appearing after dot, we have to make transition or generate item set for, you know, dot, those symbols. Okay, now let's try for the first set, the I1. In I1 you can notice that after dot there is a plus, right? So for this plus we have to generate a new item set that will be like this, E2 E plus dot jumped one step dot T. Now after dot we got a non-terminal, so what we'll do for that non-terminal, we have to add production rules headed by that non-terminal. Okay, so here that non-terminal is T. Okay, so let's see, T gives us T2 dot T multiplication F and T2 dot T, right? Again, sorry, T2 dot F, right? Again, F came after dot, so we have to consider it, right? So F gives two production rules, F2 dot opening bracket E closing bracket and F to dot ID, right? So we got another production item set here, and we gave this item set name I6. Okay, so from this I1 only one item set is possible, no other item set is possible. So let's move for I2. In I2 there is two production rule, one production rule dot is at the end, so we don't have anything to do for that. But on the another production rule, dot is before the multiplication, right? So for this multiplication we will have another item set. Okay, so let's see, T2 T multiplication dot jumped by one step F. Okay. Now after dot we can find that F is there. So we have to add production rule headed by F. There are two production rules. F2 dot opening bracket E closing bracket and F2 dot ID. Okay, so we don't need to add anything else because you know all these two production rules. You can see after dot terminal symbols are coming, so we don't need to add anything. Okay, name this I7. Okay, we got I7 here. Okay, next you go to another another set where we can have some move. Okay, then I3, then we I2, then better we go to I3. If we go I4, I2 we have done, then go to I3. At I3 you can see dot is already at the end, so we can't do anything. Okay, so forget about I3 for the time being, we can't do anything here. Come to I4. Okay, here is the I4. Okay, so for I4, if you look at after dot E is there. Okay, so for E we have to process. Okay, so what we can get here? E2, E, sorry. It will be opening bracket E dot jumped one step after E, then closing bracket. Okay, so after dot closing bracket is there, so we don't need to add anything. And another is, you know, rule is there where E is there and after dot, so that will give us E2 E dot plus T. So again here also you can see after dot we have a plus sign which is terminal, so we don't need to add anything, correct? So we get these two things, make it a set and name it as I8. All right, then again look at this. Again you look at I4 and what is coming after dot. You can see after dot T is coming here, right? So you can see after dot T came here, so we have to have some transition for this T. Okay, now if you do this transition, what you will get, see E to T dot, right? And another where another place T is there after dot, so that will give us T to T dot star F. And here dot after dot there is a terminal symbol, so we can't add anything, you know, for this. Okay, so these two are the items in the item set. Okay, so we can give some name, but before that we have to take care that whether these kind of item sets are already been generated by us. If it is there, then we redirect it, this transaction, to that item set, or we can say that we are merging. Okay, now if you see this I2, this item set and this item set, they are same. So what we will do, we will just not do this. Instead we will do like this for T. All right, so just let me erase it. Okay, so for T we have done. For F, if you see, it is simply going to be T to F dot. So dot will come at the end, so we will not have anything to do, right? So it is simply going to this set for F. What else things are there after dot? Opening bracket is there. Now again, if you do this, what will happen? You see, so if I do for opening bracket, right, for this, so what will happen? It will give us first F to opening bracket dot E closing bracket. So after dot E came, so we have to add productions which are headed by E, like E to dot T, right? Sorry. E to dot E plus T, then after dot T is there, so we have to add for T also T to dot T multiplication F and T to dot F. After dot F came, so we have to add F to dot in bracket E and F to dot ID. Now if you look at this item set and this item set I4, they are same. So instead of creating a new item set or identical item set, we will simply do a self loop for this for opening bracket. Okay. So let's erase this one. Okay. So for I4, we have considered everything. Now we will go for I5. If you look at I5, dot is already at the end, so we have nothing to do. Go for I6. At I6, you can see one thing that after dot, there is a T, right? So it will give us E to E plus T dot. So dot came at the end, so we can't add anything for this, right? So for T, we are doing this movement, right? But another is there, that is, where T is appearing after dot. So we have to consider that. That is T to T dot multiplication F. Again, an after dot terminal is there, so we don't need to add anything for that. So this is the item set. How many names we have used? I8 you have given. Give here I9. Okay, so this is item set 9. Now, in I6, again, you see, after dot F is there. Okay, so what it will give, we know, it will give after dot F is there, so it will simply give T to F dot. So that is basically I3, right? So we can just have a transition like this. For F, okay? Then dot closing bracket. So we know what will happen. It will give simply this I4. You can try and you can calculate. For opening bracket, this thing is going to happen, you know. Then for ID, it is simply going to be F to ID dot. That is I5, okay? So let's send this to here for ID, okay? So for I6, we have considered everything and everything is sorted. Go for I7. At I7, we can see that after dot, we have F. So it will simply give us t to t star f dot, right? So let's create that for f. We are doing it. So it will give us t to t star f dot. Okay, so name this as i10. Okay, anything else is there? You can see closing bracket is there, sorry, opening bracket is there after dot, right? So again, it will just generate the same item set what is here, okay, for this opening bracket. Okay, then what we have there, we have id, right? So it will create f to id dot, you know where it is. Okay, so for id we will send this to i3. All right, so nothing left here in item set 7. Go to item set 8. Okay, so here I know after dot closing bracket is there, right? So for this closing bracket we can do e to opening bracket e closing bracket dot. So dot came at the end, so we don't need to add anything. So this we are naming as i11. Okay, and another is there, that is plus sign is there after dot. So if we proceed, it will be basically e to e plus dot t, and for t we have to add everything what we need to add, right? So it will basically go to this item set. If you check, it will basically go to this item set, right? This. So let's do it for plus sign. All right, so we have created all possible item sets, okay, for this given grammar. Okay, now question is that how we will use this graph, right? So this is two thing. Okay, so two things are involved here. One is this transitions we need to remember, and another is what items are there where, in which item set. Okay, so these items are also important. Okay, so what do we do? We generate a transition table from these transitions. Okay, so generating the transition table is important here. All right, so okay, so here you can see, you know, what is given in the book, the same thing we have done ourselves. Okay, now if somebody asks you